What's up, everyone? Welcome to my channel again. And today we're going to talk about a switch in a car. Before we start today's video, click the subscribe button and also follow my Instagram page, follow my Facebook page. The link are in the description below. And in the end, if you find this video interesting or you find this video informative, don't forget to leave a like button and also share it to your friend. So today I'm going to talk about a switch in a car, which its function is to adjust the height of the headlamp of the car. Well, some car don't have that switch to adjust the height of the lamp. Some car do have, and some car even have automatic adjusting. Well, for example, the Optima GT that I reviewed last time, the headlamp is automatic adjusted whenever you start your car. So you don't need to worry about the headlamp height. It adjusts automatically. But for some car, for example, Proton Persona, it does have a button to adjust the height of the headlamp. And talking about the switch, you can switch it from 0 to 0.5, 1, 1.5, and so on until 5. And I'm not sure about the unit, whether it is a 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, or 1%, 2%, 3%. But one thing I'm sure is, it is a negative value. So the switch is to lower your headlamp. And for example, in the Proton Persona, the headlamp is pretty stupidly high. I mean, it is good for me because I can see it very clearly. The headlamp is high enough, but sometimes it is blinding other's car, especially when you carry some luggage in your boot or when you have some people sitting at the back of your car. And the headlamp will become stupidly high and it just blinds the car in front. So the switch in general is actually used to lower your headlamp in that kind of situation. But what about other use? Is there any use on the headlamp adjuster? Well, I have been driving this car for 3 years and I have drive on all the states in the Semenanjung, Malaysia. I have a lot of road trip. It's now clocked at 63,000 kilometers. And throughout the trip, I realized one useful driving hacks that you can use with the lamp adjuster. And before I tell you about the hacks, just to make you clear that this is not scientifically proven, but I've tried it in like 2 times or 3 times and it actually works. So imagine you're driving on the highway late in the night and suddenly there's a rain coming down and it rains very heavily. You can't actually see what's in front and you have to drive your car slower, and you switch on your rear fog lamp, you switch on your front fog lamp, but you still can't see the front clearly because the rain or the fog is just reflecting the light from your car back to you. And what you can do is you can lower the headlamp to the lower setting, and surprisingly it does improve the visibility a lot by reducing the number of lights that reflect back to your eyes. So how is it possible? Because if there is a fog normally occurs like a few meters above the ground, and also whenever there is a fog, the fog will reflect the light back to you and make your visibility poor. This is what the fog does in nature. So by lowering the headlamp of the car, you can reduce the light that shining on the fogs and reflect to you. If there is less light reflecting back to you, it means your visibility become better. So I find this hacks very useful, especially when you're driving on the heavy rain, and especially when you're driving in Malaysia, because in Malaysia it's like sometimes it just rain without any warning. It just rain, like you're driving on the highway and then suddenly it just rain. So that's the hacks that I found in the headlamp adjuster. I mean, I don't know if it works on other car, but it does work for me like 2 times or 3 times. And honestly, is there any other use? Well, I don't really know because I really don't find any other use on this thing. And even the improved visibility is just a hack that happens to be function. So if you found any other usage on the headlamp height adjuster, feel free to comment below. Maybe I can try it next time. So I hope you find this video interesting. I hope you find this video informative. Do click the likes button, share it to your friends, and comment whatever you like. And I'll see you in the next video.